control this thing. Mount Jeremy mentioned in his book. Jeremy, you dropped your...
Mrs. Marcus?
Get off of me!
What are you doing here?
Trying to find my uncle.
Jeremy is your uncle?
Could you please? Thank you. And it's Miss Hartwood.
You don't remember me?
I remember you, Mr. Bois. I met your brother, Baptiste, earlier.
I suppose he hadn't found Jeremy either then. We spread out to find him.
Can I have this? I'm trying to get to Tarawea.
Fine, believe the rest. I just want Jeremy to come looking. We have to leave before it comes inside.
What? Where?
Come quick!
Oh, God damn my soul. I'm back at Derceto.
Reflections on the Power of the Verb in Certain Texts by Juan Luis Jorge. To act is in itself divine. Even the slightest movement of our hand is evidence of our soul in motion. Yet our free will is so easily overwhelmed by the dullness of everyday life. Our actions become rote and rigid, in spite of luxury and comfort. True divinity is found in the choice of leaving the stage where we all perform. People who discover this freedom unexpectedly will be struck by the terror of this revelation and become paralyzed, or worse, turn to suicide. However, if you are able to weather that storm, you will discover that there is a divine path beyond that fear. There is a chance to dismount your destiny and make something new. Something that hasn't been planned for or predestined. There is difficulty in explaining this type of acting, as it transcends our everyday choices. This isn't some banal decision choosing one career over the other, or even who I should marry. Leaving the stage, no matter how, isn't a matter of course correction. It's a rejection of the story that the creator is telling.
The dream of the grave under the chenier suddenly vanished, and Emily found herself back at Derceto. Instead of Jeremy, she found Lottie, who, just like her brother Baptiste, reminded her of John, who died so bravely in the war. She pushed her painful memories out of her mind and returned to her investigation. She still needed to figure out what to do with the boiler.
Wet shut. It worked. I don't have everything I need.
The Barlow lens. Instructions. To double the magnification of your telescope, simply fit this Barlow lens to your instrument. Then operate the fine tuners to adjust the distance between your lenses. This is easily done while looking through your eyepiece. Simply search for a position where your picture is clear and appears flat. When correctly tuned, your telescope should present a clear picture with magnificent magnification.
I guess this works too. Jeremy? What the hell is that? What? There was a dead body in here. Did I just imagine that?
The body of Derceto's clerk, transformed into some eye-clad abomination before he suddenly disappeared. Surely it was all in her head, a horrible vision planted by the dark man.
What's that stain? Looks like some kind of rot. It's wet shut. It worked. I need the key.
Do you teach piano as well?
Huh?
You're a governess. Did you teach those clawing casino kids how to play the piano?
How do you know about that?
Just because grown-ups don't notice children doesn't mean we don't notice you.
Yes. I taught them some piano.
Are you any good at it?
Not good enough to play a broken one.
It fell from the attic. Brought half the ceiling down.
It was Jeremy's fault, wasn't it?
Nobody knows what happened, but you're not wrong.
Doing?
I'm gonna go now. See you around.
The prick of the syringe hadn't hurt as much as the humiliation of being played by that child. Emily just couldn't make any sense of her behavior. Grace seemed amused, but not mocking. Was this just her being playful? As her feelings subsided, a second thought appeared. She wouldn't have injected her with something, would she?
Ugh. There's more of that unsettling rot.
On the commonplace of evil, there lies virtue and stark irreverence, careless thoughts of luminous indifference. But blame not the beast we once were, which science so often wished to refer. Not the wicked full of sin. It is you who stand and grin. All our good intentions aside, whereupon we build our pride. Sunless solitude, follow not this corrupting light. Prophets of confidence always crashes out of sight. Hear me, for we all bear this mark. Thus we must remain. Alone in the dark.
Hmm. Now this'll come in handy. Locked. Okay, that wasn't so bad.
Come on, Grace. I'm too tired for games. I'll even let you play with my jackknife. Oh, good evening. You haven't seen a little girl by any chance, have you?
I don't think so.
You would have known if you did. The only kid crazy enough to be in this place.
She's not in her room, then?
That would be a first. Always running around causing trouble. She's very hard to pin down, that one. You want a sip?
I'm good, thank you.
Well, I should be going then. Unless there's anything you need from me.
I just want to find my uncle before anything happens to him.
Oh, don't worry, miss. He'll show up. He is much too lily-livered to kill himself.
Why would he?
It's his greatest ambition, didn't you know? Take care now.
McCarthy moseyed off to continue his search for the little girl. Emily had meant to ask why he was looking for her, but decided against it, fearing that it would just prolong an already awkward scene.
There's something missing. So this is Grace's room. Cute.
Don't you worry, Grace. Go play your game, bleat and bellow with the others. I won't be jealous. There will be more masquerades. However, I would love it if you would finish my mask for the feast. With love, Ruth.
This must be the great Cassandra Beauregard's room. I'm not sure what I expected. Maybe something more extravagant?
Miss Beauregard, I picked up your medicine at the post office today. As you understand, it needs to be administered by the orderlies for your safety. I have put the box in Lottie's room for now, and I'm sure she will find you as soon as possible. Mr. Waits.
What's that? I need something else. I'm not sure I have everything I need. I've seen this somewhere. I'm not sure I have everything I need.
The medicine bottles had stains of rot on the labels, suggesting some greater shape. They just needed to be put in the right order. But for what purpose?
The talisman is showing another wound. Something is open. It worked. I'm in another one of Jeremy's dreams.
Emily stepped out into the humid night and found herself recognizing the Lafayette Cemetery. She hadn't been here for years, she thought, and in a way, she still hadn't returned. This was something not quite the same. Hoping she would soon get to see her uncle, she set off to find the chapel mentioned in his book.
It's been a while since I visited the family tomb. I hope it's in a better state than the real world. This. What's that for? There we go.
was the chapel where Jeremy had promised to mourn the mysterious Perosi. Maybe soon she would be able to talk to her uncle and have him end this madness. She just needed to find a way inside the chapel.
This is the chapel in Jeremy's book, and it looks like I need more medallions to open it.
Thank you.
Yeah.